Hello everyone, I'm Dr. Prashant Raman. I'm working at FMS Wisdom Banasthali Vidyapeeth as Associate Professor for the past 5 years. Prior to this, I was working with Satyam Computer Services Limited, now known as Tech Mahindra, for around 7 years as Relationship Manager. So today, we'll be covering the module Use of Information Technology in Improving Personal Effectiveness. Imagine a world where you don't have a cell phone or an internet or any kind of technology. We are living in an era of advanced technology where every part of our daily lives is related to the science of craft in one way or the other. The development of technology has led to so many amazing discoveries. Various highly developed gadgets connected to the internet have changed the way we communicate, study, work, shop, and behave. In this module, we'll be covering the following topics. What is information technology? What is personal effectiveness? How technology is getting blended with personal effectiveness, how technology has changed the workplace into a digital workplace, the various tools available in the market to improve personal effectiveness, the different tools that researchers can use with the help of social media technology, and finally, discussing the impact of technology on personal effectiveness from a teacher's perspective. So moving on to the first topic of the module, what is information technology? Information technology, commonly called as IT, is a general term describes any technology that helps to produce, manipulate, store, communicate, and disseminate information. In fact, a 1958 article in Harvard Business Review referred to information technology as consisting of three basic parts: computational data, processing, decision support, and business software. This time period marked the beginning of IT as an officially defined area of business. The next thing we are going to discuss is about personal effectiveness. Peter Drucker, one of the renowned management consultants, says that efficiency is doing things right and effectiveness is doing the right things. Every day, we spend our time and energy on achieving goals, but even the same goal can be achieved with different cost by different people. It happens because we all have different personal effectiveness. Personal effectiveness is the way people make use of their skills to improve the overall success. It concerns with how well you know yourself. By understanding your strengths and weakness, you can manage and improve your own behavior and performance. Personal effectiveness incorporates the following goals: deliver high quality work, advancement in career, time management, enhanced learning, creativity, problem solving, and decision making. We will now discuss how technology is being used to improve personal effectiveness. Technological advancements have completely changed the way data is both produced and stored, leading to a change in economic landscape. Technological improvements have helped to increase personal effectiveness. In the workplace, productivity, innovation, and efficiency are always key, and a smart blend of technology in daily life can improve the performance of an individual substantially. Technology helps increase the reliability of your work, which means that there will be fewer errors and more accurate results. Now you don't have to store your personal and official data on your hard drive, pen drive, etc. You can upload it to cloud and access anywhere, anytime. You don't need to buy the business application and have to spend time on installing on your computer and server. It's already on the cloud, which you can use it anytime from anywhere. Technology also helps to increase the speed of your work. As a result, you can complete more tasks in a shorter time span. And finally, self-sufficiency no longer guarantees effectiveness. Technology allows you to connect with different people, not only in your own organization, but with other organizations as well. You can easily leverage the intellectual property and gain insights from one another. Let us now see how technology has made the workplace digital. Workplaces are becoming digital. We are now in an age where the workplace isn't just a physical space occupied by employees during office hours. Today's workplace is an always connected environment, providing instant access to everything that employee needs. With the paperless office coming into force, sending messages through papers are getting replaced with digital workflows. In addition to saving money on paper, it allows greater efficiency for an individual to disseminate information either via email or instant messaging or through blogs. Digital tools like word processor, spreadsheet softwares, presentation softwares, calculators, etc. enables the knowledge workers to get their jobs done efficiently. These tools help an individual to increase his or her personal effectiveness at the workplace. During the earlier times, collaboration was limited to the people who were either in the same room or on the phone. Both of these methods had limitations to the number of people that could participate in a conversation at once. Now, technologies like team rooms, communities, wikis, and web conferencing has made it possible for people to collaborate on projects from across the world. An individual can create his own content with the help of the technology. With portals, internet, blogs, personalized home pages, gaining grounds, technology supports information sharing, internal publishing, and personalization of content. With the ever-improving availability of social media platforms, crowdsourcing has become a very interesting way to source ideas from the outside crowd. A person can create an ideation platform or a forum and can get information through surveys related to his or her requirements. This allows the individual to engage with a broader spectrum of sources and helps in collecting ideas, inputs, and thoughts from people around the world. And lastly, mobility. Technology has enabled today's workforce to work and operate beyond the confines of the traditional four-walled office space. As per Gallup, a research-based organization, the percentage of people who work remotely from their offices has grown in recent years, from 39% in 2012 to 43% in 2016. PCs, mobiles, etc. now provide access to company resources from almost anywhere, without being tied down to a single location. This actually helps an individual to perform multiple activities and increase personal effectiveness. Now let us discuss about some very innovative tools that are available in the market that can help you increase your personal effectiveness. There are six broad areas where information technology can really help in improving personal effectiveness. The first category is technology and productivity. There are some fascinating tools that can help in improving the productivity of a person. One such tool is Rescue Time. Rescue Time is a tool that allows you to easily understand and optimize how you spend your time and attention. This software runs in the background and tracks the applications and websites you use. You can then generate reports to discover where your time is going and set productivity goals. The next tool is Grammarly. Grammarly is an app that automatically detects potential grammar, spelling, punctuation, word choice, plagiarism, and style mistakes in writing. It can be useful when you're writing academic documents or reviewing peers' work. As an individual, we need to stay organized. One way to stay organized is to prepare a to-do list. Gone are the days when you prepared the list manually. Today, technology can help you in creating lists very easily. One such tool is Todoist. Todoist is a powerful to-do list platform where you can create tasks and subtasks, attach priority labels, share and discuss items with your friends and colleagues, and set up recurring events. There are certain individuals who find managing projects very stressful. They are not sure about the project completion date and who all are working on the project, etc. To provide solution to these issues, there is an interesting software called Trello. Tasks are visualized as cards, which can be grouped into boards and assigned to individuals, so you can see at a glance who is working on what. Cards can be updated with comments, links, attachments, and other relevant information, and automatic notifications ensure you are kept in the loop. And so, you no longer have to worry about the status of the project and can control the timelines of the project with ease. The next category that helps in improving personal effectiveness is availability of online training resources. With the help of technology, you can now search for any online course that fits your requirements. It is not necessary now to wait for a course of your choice to be delivered at any physical location and then getting yourself registered. Technology has made it possible for an individual to learn from the various online platforms available from the convenience of his or her home or office. Here, we will be discussing some of the online resources that you can use to improve your knowledge base. The first one is the Swayam platform. Swayam stands for Study Webs of Active Learning for Young Aspiring Minds. It's a program of Ministry of Human Resource Development, Government of India. Here, a learner can choose from hundreds of courses which are interactive, prepared by the best teachers in the country, and are available free of cost to the residents in India. However, fees would be levied in a case learner requires a certificate. Different national coordinators have been roped in to produce and deliver best quality content. These coordinators are AICTE for self-paced courses, NPTEL for engineering, UGC for postgraduate education, CEC for undergraduate education, NCERT and NIOS for school education, IGNU for out-of-the-school students, and IIM Bangalore for management studies. There are some other renowned online learning platforms that have been offering online courses for some time now in the market. Some of them are Coursera, which is an online learning platform founded by Stanford professors. Allison, which is regarded as a pioneer of the MOOC, Massive Open Online Courseware movement, and edX, which was founded by Harvard University and MIT in 2012. All these platforms provide courses in various fields like IT, social sciences, engineering, management, humanities, health, etc. One of the most interesting tools in this category is Duolingo. There are many people in the world who want to learn a foreign language because it might get them a better job. And learning a language is usually a costly affair. But with a tool like Duolingo, it is easy to learn any new foreign language at a low cost. Duolingo offers 81 different language courses across 37 languages. Some of the popular languages include Spanish, French, German, Hindi, etc. The next category in our discussion today will surely save you a lot of time, especially when you are traveling. Increased congestion on the roads and issues related to traffic hampers our timelines. We are not able to reach our destination on time, and that affects our work. Technology can help us to identify the fastest route quickly. The first tool in this category is Google Maps. Google Maps is a very renowned tool offering web mapping services developed by Google. It provides satellite imagery street maps, 360-degree panoramic views of streets, real-time traffic conditions, and route planning. Google has partnered globally with 800 public transport providers to adopt general transit feed specification, making the data available to third parties. Waze and InRoute are other such tools available in this category that crowdsources traffic information from the drivers and helps you find the fastest path. An interesting tool related to people who often travel overseas where they don't want to use their roaming data is Copilot GPS. You'll need to download map only once, and then you can go turn by turn voice direction, plan new routes, and use Google powered search to save new places or addresses for when you are offline. The next category is online storage space. Online storage systems, or cloud services as they are also known, allow you to store digital media online by uploading via your computer or mobile device. So there is no need to carry those extra storage devices along with you. The two most well-known tools in this category are OneDrive and Google Drive. OneDrive and Google Drive are both file hosting service operated by Microsoft and Google respectively, and allow users to store files on their servers, synchronize files across devices, and share files. Apple iCloud and Dropbox also work on the similar lines and are other popular tools in this category. The next category is a product in itself and can be very useful for the teachers. Office 365 is the product of Microsoft. Office 365 Education is a comprehensive platform of tools and apps that provides teachers, staff members, and students with access to communication tools, document editing, file sharing, storage, email, class websites, assignments, classroom materials, and much more. Everything is accessed in the cloud to promote collaboration, learning, and improved productivity in real time. The first feature of this product is Microsoft Classroom. Microsoft Classroom is a home page that helps students and teachers manage classroom materials and assignments using intuitive classroom management tools. Using Microsoft Classroom, teachers can manage handouts, create quizzes and assignments, etc. Additionally, there are tools for managing grades, collaborating with the students, and accessing materials in the event of student not present in the school. The other interesting features of Office 365 products are Outlook Web App and Link Online. Outlook Web App allows you to view and share calendars online, set up meetings, and configure automatic reminders. And Link Online allows you to open up your classroom to students who are absent from school by making a call to the student on your PC at the start of a lesson, and then you simply use screen sharing to allow the student to participate in the lesson. With the help of OneNote and SharePoint, classroom material can be shared across communities before the scheduled lectures, and teachers can use it as a flipped classroom. The last category in this section is related to the effective ways to communicate with others. Technology can make interfacing much simpler than it used to be. Skype is perhaps one of the best known online meeting tools. Its functionality spans from the basic meetings all the way to web conferences and even online learning sessions. It supports meetings of up to 250 users. Skype allows users to communicate over the internet by voice, by video, and by instant messaging. The other products in this category which are very popular are GoToMeeting and Cisco's WebEx. Now, we move on to the role of social media technology in the life of a researcher. Researchers have highlighted many common reasons for using social media, like sharing information, recognition and exposure, access to others' work, building connections with funders, industry partners, and self-promotion and branding. ResearchGate, LinkedIn, and academia.edu are social networking sites for researchers to share papers, ask and answer questions, and find collaborators. Google Scholar, on the other hand, provides a simple way to broadly search for scholarly literature, like articles, theses, books, abstracts, academic publishers, etc. There are certain social citation tools that helps the researcher in citing different reference material. One of the tools is CiteYouLike. CiteYouLike allows users to save and share citations to academic papers. Based on the principle of social bookmarking, the site works to promote and develop the sharing of scientific references amongst researchers. On the similar lines, Mendeley, Zotero, and Quika are reference management software that helps you organize research, collaborate with others online, manage bibliographic data, and discover the latest research. Finally, to conclude this module, there are some points related to how technology has improved the personal effectiveness of a teacher. First, technology has helped in improving the student and teacher engagement. One of the simplest of all technologies, emails, are being used to communicate with the students. Emails have replaced all conventional modes of communication in tech-savvy countries and are already used as a mode of communication between the teacher and the students. Announcements of assignments, submission of homework, etc. are now already moved onto the digital classroom. Second is the improvement in the speed and accuracy of the feedback given to the students. With many electronic gradebook software available in the market, teachers can keep the track of grading histories and profiles for every student and counsel them about problems as soon as they occur. Teachers can videotape student presentations to evaluate and maintain record of student performance as a part of assessment activities. These types of feedbacks would go far beyond establishing a grade for the student and will help in the student progress better. Third, is easy to bring new resources into the classroom. As technologies have become more widely available, it has made it increasingly easy for teachers to access a broader range of material that they can use in the classroom. A teacher can bring a timely article from the morning newspaper into class, scan it, and have the students work on rewriting, editing, or adding research to the story on the same day. And lastly, technology helps in increased collaboration. Technology has made it possible for the teachers to collaborate on research projects. They can arrange virtual video conferences with presentations on the screen that allow other experts to look at the same data at once. With the increased number of minds working on a given project, everyone is able to offer their own expertise. This increases the amount of collaboration across educational institutes and allows an individual to quickly and efficiently arrive at the strongest conclusion, boosting efficiency and productivity. So this brings us to the end of the module, and I hope you might have got a brief understanding of how technology helps in improving personal effectiveness. Thank you.